Hey, hello, what's up everyone? In this video, I'm going to continue the basic astrology for absolute beginners. That is the fourth part. Okay, from the fifth house, I'm going to start. So before beginning, if you guys not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel, click the bell icon and click the like button. And if you guys have any doubt after watching this video, please do mention that in my below comment section, okay? And as please do again for my Facebook community page, Parikshit Astrology also. So let's begin. Now, coming to the fifth house. The fifth house influences our intelligence, creative and innovative abilities. If you have artistic abilities, they are coming out well and giving us happiness. It is happening because of favorable planetary positions in our fifth house. The fifth house also deals with all that you create, including your children. The ease or difficulty with which you beget babies is influenced by the fifth house. Even developments like conception, miscarriage, relationship with your children and their health are governed by the fifth house. Children are like your extension, so raising them is pleasurable. They are seen a way. You are nurturing yourself and ensuring that you continue even after your physical death in the form of your progeny. Thus, the fifth house is also referred to as Putra Bhava in Vedic astrology. Besides the body parts, which the fifth house rules include the stomach, upper and middle back, pancreas and spine. So these are all the body parts. Now the fifth house also determines your sense of discrimination. How do you use reason and judgment to understand and manage your surroundings in the best possible manner? This house also caters to intelligence, analytical skills, coherence in taking effective decisions, righteous and the prospects of higher education. In other words, the fifth house is about refinement in an individual. It is about the intellectual and finer side of human identity. Thus, it is the criterion between the coarse and the cultured, an important determinant for the mental level of an individual as per the fifth house astrology. The fifth house also determines your luck and good fortune in gambling or speculative activities. The risks that you face in a speculative monetary activities can also be gauged by analyzing your fifth house. All the games and developments that are based on the chance factor are dependent on the fifth house. This includes puzzles, stock market trading, sudden monetary gains, racing, betting, casinos, cards, and so on, in accordance with the fifth house in Vedic astrology. Now, the sixth house in Vedic astrology is usually about health and well-being. Besides, good health also extends to have a brave attitude to fight the difficulties of life. Everybody makes mistakes, has shortcomings, and face various types of challenges. How we deal with these challenges is the factor determined by the planetary position that prevails in sixth house. This house is also about our fears and how we deal with the accordings with the sixth house of astrology. The sixth house in Kundli is also known as Shatru Bhava in Vedic astrology. It relates to the sixth house. It relates to the sixth sign in Virgo. So if I do any mistakes, please bear with me, guys. The natural significance of this house is planet Mercury. It is the best house for Mercury, but the weak house for Jupiter, Sun, Moon, Venus, and Saturn. Service and employability are the central themes as far as the sixth house in astrology is considered. The position in the sixth house decides things like what type of work should you do, whether job will suit you or you will be more successful in business. How will you be with your seniors? What type of colleagues and seniors will get? How will be your equation with those who rely upon you for their bread and butter and so on? However, you have to be careful about your health, consume healthy food and do regular exercise as per the sixth house astrology. The sixth house rules various body parts like stomach, intestines and digestive tract. It also refers to the armed forces that protect the nation. Well, the sixth house in a horoscope is about obstacles, hostilities, challenges, debts, etc. The sixth house drives the native, makes him or her stronger and enables him or her to overcome all these problems. According So the sixth house is more related to the people like doctors, healers, and other professionals who help the society, like police, army persons, etc. Besides, the sixth house in Vedic astrology also deals with the disputes, legalities, lawsuits, and so on. Seventh house. Now coming to the seventh house. The seventh house in astrology is about partnerships, the most important being the wedlock or marriage. The seventh house in the house series makes a big shift in analyzing the destiny of an individual. Till the house number six, the focus was on self and issues related to the self. But house number seven onwards, the focus shift to the other. The first and the foremost is your marriage and your life partner. The seventh house is also known as the Kalatra Bhava in Vedic astrology and is ruled by the Libra sign. Planet Venus is the natural significator of this house as per the seventh house Vedic astrology. The seventh house is a house which is very weak for Jupiter and Sun, but it is the best house for Moon, Mars, Mercury, Venus, and Saturn. The seventh house influences things between you and your life partner and other partners like business partner and so on. Thus, the attraction to the opposite gender, the need for commitment in a relationship, shades of passion, physical intimacy, and related fantasies, level of understanding, all these are governed by the seventh house compatibility. Now, the body parts influenced by the seventh house include kidney and lower back. So, the seventh house has lots in it for our relationships, and relationships are really very important in your life because it is the relationship that connects us to the people around us and everyone in this world. And what lies at the core of our relationship is marriage, as the seventh house impacts our marriage in a big way. So, it is bound to influence our happiness or the lack of it in a very substantial manner. Besides, the seventh house in Kundli is about your willingness to have children. It is also deals with the issues like problems and disinterest in carnal fulfillment, problems in reproductive system, infertility, and progeny problems. The seventh house also points to the reason why we take an interest in a partnership. Is it because of love, money, social pressure? The seventh house is also about cooperation and adjusting because it is what we need the most while dealing with the partner. The success in a relationship, that is especially business partnerships or professionals, also depends on situation prevailing in seventh house. The equation which we share with us, business partners and others who are close to us professionally, is bound to influence our success. Now coming to the eighth house. Eighth house occupies a prominent position amongst the 12th house of astrology. This house is often considered malefic in the Vedic astrology. The eighth house regulates the areas like death, longevity, and sudden unexpected events. The development which are triggered in one's life due to the scenario in the house number eight includes lifespan, that is long, and the problem reason for his or her death as per the eighth house astrology. The eighth house is called the Ayubhava in Vedic astrology. Deals with the Scorpio sign with the characteristics as much as mystery, possessiveness, passion, ambition. Also, Mars is the natural significator of the 8th house. It is the best house for planets Jupiter, Sun, and weak house for Moon, Mars, and Mercury. The 8th house in Kundli is also related to wealth. All the sudden and unexpected events that take place in the growth and education of wealth happen due to the changes triggered by the 8th house. Things like sudden gain, loss, windfall in share wealth, inheritance, insurance, etc. happen due to the 8th house. Thus, the 8th house is also called the house of transformation and mysteries, and unfavorable planetary formation in the house number 8 may cause depression, delay, dissatisfaction, and defeat. The body parts which are governed by the 8th house are the reproductive system and colon area. Well, the 8th house is strongly linked. The 8th house is strongly linked to the sharp variations in different areas of life, including wealth, fortune, and so on. It is the destiny which has a lot of ups and downs and highs and lows in the areas which are linked to the human happiness. A good planetary position in the 8th house can boost the fortunes of a native enormously. On the other hand, an adverse alignment here in can mark troubles, difficulties, and challenges. If the planets in 8th house in horoscope are afflicted, it may affect the longevity of that person. It may cause immoral chronic illness and various forms of misery, mental peace, and may be lost. There may even be monetary issues, criminal involvement, penalty or punishment, addiction, deformities, losing the loved ones, death and other types of problems, On the other hand, if the eighth house is positive, it may have several positive outcomes. Like the person may have a long life and he or she is likely to overcome oppositions and enemies. Besides, those who have strong planetary positions in the eighth house, more inclined towards the metaphysics subject and issues related to psychic abilities. These people are also masters in academic subjects like psychology, science, mathematics, and paranormal studies, as depicted in the ethos Vedic astrology. So yeah, this is it for the guys. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe below, or else I'll see you in the next video. So if you want any consultancy, please do contact my given below WhatsApp number, or else you can even mail me also. So until and unless, thank you, bye bye, love you, take care.